Hi, it's Paris from Epic Reviews of Tech Channel, and I've just finished reviewing the Google Nexus 4, a very nice phone, but sadly the day usually comes in every phone owner's life where you need to reset the phone. It's just gotten too messed up, and so you want to wipe it all and start over again and do a factory reset. Well, there's two ways you can do it. One is in the software, one is in the hardware, and I'll take you through the steps on both of those here. Keep in mind that this will erase everything on your phone, so photos, videos, music, whatever you have on here that you don't have backed up somewhere else will be gone. But if this is what you need to do, it's what you need to do. So you want to go into settings. This is assuming the phone is still running well enough that you can get to this point. Go into settings, scroll down the list of settings until you get to backup and restore. And right here is the factory data reset. And they're warning you here, this will erase all data from your phone, including your Google account, your settings, your downloads, your music, your photos. They just want to be real sure you understand that. If you understand that, then we're going to go here to reset phone. And you get one more warning about it really will erase everything. We're not kidding. And you say, okay, erase everything. It's restarted. Now we're in Android maintenance mode here. Underneath the little guy it says erasing. It's restarted again. May stay on this screen a little longer than you're used to. It's got to finish the reset procedure. Can take a minute or more. And here we are. The factory reset's been done, and I'd like to know what language we'd like to use the phone in. So this really is a back to when you first took it out of the box kind of restore. At this point, you set it back up, reattach it to your Google account, and if it's done a recent backup and things are working well, then it will load your contacts and some settings back into the phone from that backup, and you should be all set to go. Sometimes though the phone gets so messed up that you can't even get into the operating system to do the reset and you need to do a hardware reset. So let me show you the steps for that. To do a hardware reset of the Google Nexus 4, because it's so messed up that you can't get into the software to do it that way, there's a number of non-intuitive steps involved here, so you may want to make a note of these or follow along with your phone on the video here. Now to start with, to get into the first stage, you're going to need to hold the volume down button of the rocker on the side, press and hold that, and then on the opposite side, the power button, you're going to press and hold the power button. Here we go. Felt that little vibration, and here we are. You notice it said start there. I think by letting go, it jumped to the next one. But basically on this screen, this is an informational screen. If you have some reading glasses handy, you can find out all about the innards of your phone here, but we don't care about that right now. We're looking at the fallen Android, and it says to restart bootloader, and then these up and down arrows here by the volume rocker are telling you that the touchscreen doesn't work in this mode, and you'll need to use the up and down rocker here to choose, and then when you want to select that choice, you hit the power button. So a little confusing. Anyway, if you've gotten this far, what we're going to do now is use the up and down rocker here of the volume button until we get to where it says recovery mode. There is recovery mode. Now we're to choose that, to select it, we're going to press the power button in and let go. So I've selected recovery mode. And it's going to come up with an Android with an exclamation point on it. Okay, now we're halfway to the next mode because this says no command. The next step's a little tricky because you have to hold the power button first and hold it in and then tap volume up. Oh, there's power. I'm going to press and hold it first. I guess with this hand I'll do volume up. Holding power, volume up. Okay, so now we've got even smaller type print options. Let me go grab my reading glasses. All right, now I can see. It says volume up down to move highlight, power button to select. It's by default, it's at reboot system now. If I go down one with the volume, I'm on apply update. Go down another one, wipe data slash factory reset, and the last one is wipe cache partition, but we're on the one we want. which if you can't see this, you go down two from the one you start out in. So you're going to start out with reboot system now. If you can't read this, and you don't want to go out and buy reading glasses, go down one, two. Second one from the bottom is wipe data slash factory reset. And to select it, you go back over to the power button and tap that. Now, this says confirm wipe of all user data. This cannot be undone. Again, they're warning you here. You're going to lose everything, so be aware of it. And all the options here are no, 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 no. Then there's a yes, delete all user data. No, no, no. So they don't want you to accidentally delete everything on your phone. I'm going to go down. Let's see. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So again, if you can't read what's on the screen, if you go down seven from where it is at default, you select yes, delete all user data. Again, the power button to select it. Here we go, wiping data, formatting. Down under the little Android guy, it says erasing. Okay, data wipe complete. Up here, we're back to those original options of the first tiny print screen, and the default, which was reboot system now, is still the default, and that's what we want this time. We want to restart it. It's selected. We just need to go to the power button and press it. And it takes a little longer than most startups, about a minute or so for it to start up because it has to complete the reset. So there you are. Welcome to your new phone. Basically, that's what it is. Everything's been erased on it. It's back to just how it was when you took it out of the box. And I understand them trying to make it so you don't accidentally delete everything on your phone. You wouldn't want that to happen, but it seems to me they go kind of too extreme with all the things you have to do the hardware reset. Anyway, if you've made it this far and your phone is showing this screen, you're now ready to go through these personalization screens and set your phone back up with your Google account, and hopefully everything got backed up and it'll put it back on your phone and you'll be good to go.